Hi students, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will explain how to develop a simple program using KEIL software and 8051 microcontroller. This is very useful for beginners. So this is KEIL Microvision 5. Click on this icon. A window is opened. So I want to create new project. So go to project, click on new Microvision project. So I will give name to the project. Project name is India. Okay, that is saved in Somesh folder. Click on save. So after creating the project, a target window is opened. So here many vendors listed. Above semiconductors, Acer Labs, Aeroflex, Altium, analog device, anchor chips. But academic purpose, especially for beginners, Atmel 89C51 is most preferable. Why? Because it is most compatible to Intel 8051 microcontroller. After selecting Atmel 89C51, here description window shows the properties of 89C51 chip. It is 8051 based, 24 MHz, CMOS controller, 32 I/O lines, 2 timer and counter, 6 interrupts. It's more compatible with 8051 microcontroller. So here click on OK. So copy startup.a51 to project folder. No need to copy any startup file, already existed. So simply click on No. Here project India target is created. OK. Then go to file, click on new. So click on new, a new file is opened. Again go to file, save as. I will give name to this file, LED blink.asm. So I want to develop program in assembly language. That's why here .asm is the extension. If it is in C language, embedded C, simply .c is the extension. So click on save. So LED blink.asm is saved in Somesh folder. That means my folder. Okay. After that, this LED blink.asm must be added to the source group. Otherwise, if it is not added, program will not compile. So we have to add LED blink.asm to source group. Right click on source group and add existing file to group source group. Click on this add files and choose LED blink. Here file type is asm. Simply click on add. So close. So this LED blink.asm is added to the source group. Just click on this plus symbol. So LED.asm is added to the source group. Okay. Now I would like to write simple LED interface program. For example, just observe this figure. Here 8051 microcontroller is LED connected to the LED. For example, assume port 1.0 pin is connected to P1.0 is connected to LED and cathode is connected to the ground, anode is connected to port 1.0. Okay, that means if port 1.0 is equal to 1, simply this diode becomes forward bias and it will be on stage. Okay, suppose if port 1.0 is equal to 0, simply it is an off state. Why? Because 0 is connected to this anode. As a result, diode becomes reverse biased. Simply LED is off state. Okay. So the logic is very simple. Port 1.0 is equal to 1, LED on. Port 1.0 pin is equal to 0, LED is off. So continuous blinking means this process must be continues as long as the supply is present, as long as the program is in run. running. Okay, so first org 0000h. Org stands for origin directive in 8051 microcontroller. Next, I want to clear the port 1, move p1 comma hash 00h. So 00h is loaded into the port 1. Hash indicates immediate addressing mode. Next, set BP1.0. Assume LED is connected to port 1.0 pin. That's why here set BP1.0 indicates P1.0 is equal to 1. A call delay, absolute call delay. After that, clear P1.0. So 1.0 is equal to 0 LED offset. Again, A call delay. So this process must be continuous as long as the program is in running. So that's why we need one jump instruction, SJMP, short jump. Here the label is up. Again, up. Okay, right? SJMP up, short jump up. So this process continues. Here control is transferred to third line. So again, set BP1.0, some delay, clear B1.0, some delay, again SJMP up. This process is continuous. Okay, now I would like to develop delay program. DELAY, delay. How to develop delay program? Move R5 comma hash 200. That means 200 is loaded into the R5. So 200 is the decimal number. That's why I don't want to give any H. So next, DJNZ R5, decrement jump not equal to 0, comma here control is transferred to here only. Okay, so just observe these two lines. Move R5 comma hash 200. 200 is loaded into the R5. Decrement jump on no 0. Decrement 200 becomes 199. But it is not equal to 0. So again here, see, again decrement 199 becomes 198. Not equal to 0. Again here. So this loop is continuous until R5 reaches 0 value. So if R5 is equal to 0, this loop is terminated. This loop is terminated and next instruction is executed. Next instruction is RET, return. Okay, after that ENT. So just observe the entire program. Initially P1 is loaded with 00, port 1 is clear. Set B P1.0, that means 1.0 is equal to 1. 1.0 is equal to 1. Simply, this anode is connected to 1. So simply LED in on state, followed by our LED is in on state. So next instruction A call delay. So the control is transferred to 8th line, delay. So R5 is loaded to 200. Entire this delay is created by using 8 and 9 lines. Move R5 comma hash 200, DJNZ instructions. After that, return RET. Again, control is transferred to 5th line, CLR P1.0. That means P1.0 is equal to 0. So P1.0 is equal to 0. What happens simply? This 0 is connected to anode of the LED. So LED is in off stage. Simply, it is reverse bias. So LED is in off stage. Next, A call delay, absolute call delay. Again, control is transferred to 8th line and delay program is performed. After that, RET, return. Again, control is transferred to SJMP, 7th line. SJMP up. Here, label address is up. again control is transferred to line 3. So this process is continuous as long as the program is running. Okay, program is running and supply is on. This process is continuous. Okay, so after that simply click on save. So this program is saved, and just observe this icon, build target files. Click on this build target files. So here in output window, project name is India, errors 0, warnings 0. Okay, so how to run this program? Go to debug, start debug session. Here evaluation mode, running with code size limit 2k. Okay, click on OK. Okay, again go to debug, run. So where you get result, just observe the port 1.0 pin. Where you get this result, go to peripherals and choose IO port and select port 1. Just observe the port 1.0 pin. Okay, so this program is used to interface the LEDs. LED, a single LED. Okay, again, debug, start, debug session. Okay, so I want to create the hex file. How to create a hex file? Go to target, right click on target. So there is a one window, one options for target one. Click on options for target one. So here options for target window is opened, and go to output and just create hex file. Click on create hex file. Okay, select create hex file. Here name of the executable file is India. Okay, simply put, click on OK. Right, so again save the file and go to build and click on this build target files. Just observe this output window, creating hex file from objects India. Hex file is created. So just observe the folder in on desktop. So mesh folder, go to folder, again go to objects. Here hex file is created, hex hex file. Open this hex file, we get this hexadecimal code. So this is very important. This actually this hex file is dumped into the microcontroller. So hex file generation is very, very important as far as concerned our projects. So thank you students. Thank you.